So the manjal kashayam is ready. Cheers. Hi folks, welcome to an episode of GOTR Raw. Now this is an episode with a difference because I'm filming at home and that's my wife Shridevi there.
Hi everybody.
So we're living in very challenging times, I think all of us are. Well, we've been homebound for the last few days and I'm sure many of you, as this video is being filmed, as this video will hopefully be released, are also homebound. And there's a lot of uncertainty around, there's a lot of fear, there's a lot of confusion, a lot of rumors as well. But I think the only thing that we can do is really stay calm, sit calm through all of this and do the best that we can to cope with things indoors. So yesterday she was in the kitchen and she was making a potion that she normally makes every other day, and this is made with fresh turmeric. And so as she was preparing it yesterday, I just kind of took a little clip of that and put it up on Instagram. And I asked our viewers whether you would be interested in knowing more about this and also learning the recipe. And I was amazed by the overwhelming number of responses that I received requesting for the recipe. And that's why I thought we'll film this GOTR episode at home with Shri, where she will tell us a little more about this potion that she makes and also share with us the recipe. So Shri, what's this all about?
This is like a age-old, you know, Indian grandma recipe. We call it kashayam.
Kashayam.
We call it kashayam in Tamil, you know, we call it manjal kashayam. In Telugu, Karnataka, all the people, you know, they make kashayam whenever the person is unwell and stuff like that. Especially it's very, very good for cold, cough, allergies and muscular pains.
Where is the recipe for this manjal kashayam? Manjal means turmeric.
Manjal means turmeric.
In Tamil.
In Tamil.
Okay, and where does this recipe come from?
It comes from Thanjavur, from my grandfather. He was an Ayurvedic doctor.
Okay.
So when we were kids, you know, like especially during winter months and all, you know, he would make this kashayam and he would make us, you know, like give one shot. You know, it's like a shot we used to take.
Alright, so tell me, when your grandfather gave it to you, then did you enjoy it?
Oh, when we were kids, you know, like we would put, you know, he would give us with lot of jaggery. He would put us either honey and jaggery so that, you know, like we would enjoy it. Now, sometimes, you know, like without jaggery and honey, anything, I just drink it because of health benefits. And for the kids, whenever I give it to my kids, you know, like I make sure I add a little bit more of jaggery so that, you know, like they'll drink it.
So now you've been doing this at home?
For the last 10 years.
For the last 10 years,
right? Last 10 years, yes.
So the kashayam is a part of your daily...
Yes, yes. It's like, you know, like in the morning, I'll have my cup of coffee and after half an hour or so, I'll have like one cup of this kashayam.
Well, I must also say here that I'm not a regular consumer of this kashayam. So, I typically would have it, let's say, if I've got a bit of a cold or something, she'll give me. But now, I think for the last few days, this is part of my daily intake. So, every morning, I'll have half a cup of that kashayam. So, anyway, enough talking about the kashayam. I think what you're really here for is the recipe. So, let's go into our kitchen here and look at the making of that kashayam. Let's go. So here we are in the kitchen and she's got all her ingredients for the making of the manjal kashayam.
Kashayam.
Manjal meaning turmeric in Tamil. So Shri, what goes into the making of the kashayam?
See, there are about like 9 to 10 ingredients.
Okay.
And the most important thing is this fresh turmeric. The turmeric is very well washed, remove all the mud particles, everything, properly clean it.
But with the skin.
Yes.
So you want the skin intact.
Yes, yes.
Alright.
The second ingredient is ginger. Ginger is also like how you have washed your turmeric, like that you have to nicely wash it, remove all the, you know, like mud, everything from that. If it is too dirty, then maybe you can scrape it off a bit, you know, like whatever it is. But by and large, try to, you know, like use with the skin. Anyway, you are boiling it off so that, you know.
So what are the other ingredients that go into it?
2 teaspoons of pepper, okay. 2 teaspoons of jeera, 1 teaspoon of cloves or long, 1 teaspoon of cardamom, 6 to 7 sticks of cinnamon, and 3 to 4 teaspoons of jaggery, this is optional. 1.5 to 2 teaspoons of carom seeds or ajwain, this is also optional.
Okay, so those were all the ingredients that go into it, and then of course you have the water.
Water.
Because all these ingredients are boiled in the water.
Yes.
So how much water do we have here?
1.5 liters of water.
1.5 liters of water.
Yes.
Okay, so now that the water is boiling, what's the next step?
Nicely wash your hands and then start grating the turmeric. Fresh turmeric is preferable, but nowadays, you know, like throughout the year you get, there are some months if you don't get it, that time, you know, you can use turmeric powder instead.
So that's the fresh turmeric that's grated right there. I mean, it's a very different sort of aroma, right?
Yes, so the very nice. It's very, very nice.
So it's aromatic, yet it kind of somehow smells also a little medicinal.
Yes.
At the same time. Okay, so next it's time to grate the ginger. So as the ginger is being grated, you can smell the fresh, warming aroma of the ginger there. So we have our ginger ready, but also before the ginger and the turmeric goes into the water, I forgot to mention one thing here. That Shri has not only learned this recipe from her grandfather, of course, who was an Ayurveda practitioner in Thanjavur, but she's also a qualified nutritionist by profession. So sometimes, many a times people ask me, so how do you keep yourself fit and things like that? So well, I'm doing a lot of eating outside, but when I come home, it's Shri who takes care of all my nutrition at home. And so I guess perhaps to a certain extent that also helps. So when she prepares this recipe, so there's a lot of thought that she puts into it. So of course, it's age-old wisdom, it's ancient wisdom that's come through the generations. So this came from your grandfather in Thanjavur.
That's right.
And then your mom used to prepare this.
That's right.
And now she prepares it at home. But then she's also applying her nutritionist mind to it and seeing how she can make it.
See, it's very, very healthy. It's full of antioxidants. This is even in the US and abroad, Western countries are, you know, like drinking as a turmeric latte and all that, because they started last couple of years, because turmeric has curcumin, which is very, very good. It's anti-cancerous and, you know, anti-inflammatory. Even the ginger is very good for health. It keeps you away from getting cold, cough and all the allergies.
So basically, each one of these ingredients has their own benefits, whether it's the turmeric, whether it's the ginger, the pepper, the cumin seeds, the cloves, the cardamom, or the ajwain. But when you put them together, I think it packs a powerful, healthy punch. That's what's going to happen now with the turmeric.
Before boiling itself, you can start putting all the ingredients. I'm putting now the freshly grated turmeric.
Immediately the turmeric stains that water orange. You know, all the vessels that you will use to create this potion, all of them will be stained, right?
So you keep one vessel aside for this particular potion, you know?
You know, so when I was shooting today and I saw this, I'm like, you know, we can't shoot with this because this is already stained, you know, it looks dirty on camera, etc. But she said, you know, whatever you do with turmeric, which is a fact. So for example, I just touched that turmeric for a teeny weeny moment and our hands are already stained. So the vessels that you will use, the spoons that you will use when you're making this turmeric potion or this manjal kashayam will be stained. So keep aside that vessel or that, you know, or whatever you use to make this.
Now the ginger.
The ginger goes in. And you want to put this before it starts boiling.
Yeah.
So just when it's simmering. So the fresh turmeric and the ginger is now simmering away out there. So what happens next?
The remaining ingredients you have to put in a blender and blend it. And add it to this potion.
Of course, and I think earlier we used to also use this mortar and pestle. So
yes.
If you have the time and the patience, and if you have that, you can do that. But you know, at homes you want to kind of do it quick. So
right.
You want to use your blender to grind all those ingredients. Well, so the mix of all those ingredients is ready now. I think you can smell the ajwain right away. You can smell the heat of the pepper and also that cumin.
Yes.
Right? So the moment you open that mixer jar, you can smell all those ingredients. So basically, of course, I mean, you know, Shri is so used to doing this by herself without my interference, without the camera. I've been, you know, trying to shoot it in the best possible way. But what you can really do is get those ingredients, get everything ready together.
Yes.
So even the dry ingredients, which is the pepper, the cloves, the ajwain, the cinnamon, all of that. So you can grind it all together and you can put it in quick succession. So you
yes.
can put the turmeric, you can put the ginger and then the powders as well.
Sometimes, you know, like you can also make it in one small box also, you can keep it aside. And then every day, you know, like you can, when you are boiling this turmeric, that time you can add couple of spoons also in that.
So, should we put these ingredients
yes.
in now?
Yeah, all of them we can put. Now you kind of stir it a bit. Once it comes to a boil, you can switch it off.
So, this is the kashayam which is now ready. So this is the kashayam in its purest form.
Right.
Right. And then depending on your taste, depending on your likes, dislikes, you can add in other ingredients.
Yeah, you can add in like pudina leaves. You can add in little bit of, you know, like lemon or honey instead of jaggery. If you prefer honey, you can add honey.
So now that this is ready, so how long can we keep this?
This you can keep it for 2 days.
For 2 days?
Yeah.
And does it have to be kept in the fridge or
no,
outside?
No. You can keep it outside. Nothing will happen.
You can keep it outside at room temperature.
Yes. No problem.
And so when you are ready to drink it the next day, you heat it up a bit?
Yes. Again, you have to heat it up a bit.
So the manjal kashayam is ready. Cheers. So mine is with jaggery.
Yes.
And yours is without jaggery.
Without jaggery.
So basically, you know, earlier I used to be very squeamish about tasting all of this. But once you start drinking it and you appreciate what it does for you, what it does for your system.
Yes.
I think you enjoy it. So when you taste it first, it does of course taste very medicinal. And I think that jaggery makes it a tad more tolerable for me at least. But...
No, if you feel it's too concentrated, maybe you can add a little bit more water.
Okay.
You can add a little bit more water so that, you know, like for children and all, it's more drinkable.
I think you have that sweetness that comes from the jaggery, but
right.
beyond that, it's all the other ingredients. You can definitely feel the heat of the pepper. You can feel the heat of the cloves.
Yes.
And I think that turmeric is what you taste on your palate long after you taste all these other ingredients.
That's right.
Right, and you can taste the warming heat of the ginger as well.
Absolutely. It's very, very good. In the last 10 years, I have not got cold, cough, sore throat, nothing. I just drink this only this much.
But you drink it every day?
Every single day.
Every day is the sweet first. And then the heat from all the spices.
That's right.
The cardamom, the pepper, the cloves.
Right.
That's what you taste.
Right.
And of course, the flavor of the turmeric. So this is an acquired taste. It's not something that will endear itself to you on the first sip. But knowing what it does for your system, I think you begin to appreciate it slowly.
Yeah.
So we hope you enjoyed this very special episode of GOTR Raw, shot in our home, in our kitchen. Thank you very much, Sri, for sharing this recipe with everybody out there. Do try it in your kitchen. It's a very easy, very simple recipe. It doesn't take too much effort at all. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and
happy eating.
Happy eating or drinking.